Everyone, this is video number 23. Okay, and in this video, what we will do, we will learn more about the correct use of some distributive adjectives. In the last class, I told you what are distributive adjectives: each, every, either, and neither. So many times we are confused using each, every, either, and neither. So let's clear our confusion and let's see where we will use each, where we will use every, and all that. Each is usually used to talk about two or more persons or things, and every is more appropriate for three or more people or things. Okay, so each is used when you are talking about two or more persons or thing. Each is usually used to talk about two or more person or things, and every is appropriate if you are talking about three or more people or things. For example, she held two toffees in each hand. Okay, so she held two toffees in each hand. You cannot say she held two toffees in every hand. How many hands you have? Two. So when we are talking about two or more person, it will be appropriate to use each. And if we are talking about three or more person and people, then what we will use? Every. She enjoyed every piece of candy. So the next example is, she enjoyed every piece of candy. When we will talk about two or more person or things, we will use each. And if we are talking about three or more people or things, we will use every. Next point, we use each when we think of people or things individually or wish to emphasize individuals in a group. So when you want to highlight the individual, when you want to lay stress on the individuals in a group, then you will use each. But we use every when we think of people or things together in a group. So when you want to emphasize individual in a group, then you will use each. But if you are talking about the group together, and if you are thinking about the people or the things together in a group, then you will use every. Now it will be clear with the help of an example. See, each child in the classroom was painting a picture. So I want to emphasize that each child. So I have written, each child in the classroom was painting a picture. I am laying stress on each individual. So each child. Next part. And every picture was colorful. Here I am not talking about each picture. I am not laying stress on the individual picture. What I am doing, I am taking it collectively and I am talking about the people or the things together. I am talking about the things together. So what they have written, and every picture was colorful. So you will use each when you want to emphasize individual in a group, and you will use every when we think of people or things together in a group. Next point, either indicates any one of a group. So either will indicate any one of a group, and neither indicates none of the group. Either indicates any one of a group, neither indicates none of the group. For example, either boy can answer the phone means anyone can answer the phone, anyone in the group can answer the phone. But neither boy must open the door means none of the boys in the group. Either boy can answer the phone, but neither boy must open the door. Either indicates any one of a group, and neither indicates none of the group. So we have done today how to use each, every, either, and neither. Now related to this topic, we have an exercise. Now we will try to solve that exercise. See this exercise. Okay. No need of doing this exercise in your fair copy. You will do this exercise in the book itself. Okay. At last, I will tell you which exercises you need to do in your copy. This exercise need not of doing in copy. Do it in the book itself. Dash answer is worth 5 points. Now see here, I will lay emphasis and emphasize answer. So I will use each answer is worth 5 points. They enjoyed blank meeting of the film. The answer will be they enjoyed every minute of the film. This magazine has a new issue blank week. So this magazine has a new issue every week. All students must be on time on every day. All students must be on time on every day. Each of the two boys promise to complete their work quickly. Each of the two boys promise to complete their work quickly. See, here we were talking about only two person, two boys. So I taught you that if there are two or more people, what we will use each. Every child who participates in the competition will receive a prize. Here we are talking collectively, so we will use every. Every child who participates in the competition will receive a prize. Hope this exercise is clear. So do this exercise in book itself. Exercise D. Exercise D also we will do in book, not in copy. Use the correct adjectives of number from the help box to fill in the blanks. I stood third in the race. You have to take the help from the help box. Words are given. You have to choose the words from the help box. Blank book contained the correct answer. The answer will be neither book contained the correct answer. Will either one of you help me with the project? Question number 4. In a baker's dozen, there are 13 loaves of bread. Fifth, every boy was wearing a cap. We are talking about, we are not laying emphasis on each, means individual, so we will use every. And each cap had a different design. Okay. Question number 6. The apple tree is laden with so many apples this year. Last year we got just a few apples. So we have done this also. Now we will move to next exercise. See this exercise. Exercise B. Exercise B, page number 19. Again, this exercise also you will do in book only. No need of doing it in copy. Mark the answers in book. And this exercise is very easy. Fill in the blanks with appropriate adjective. I will discuss only question 1 to 5. Rest you can do. She picked the first dress she saw. Question number 2. Which dress will you wear tonight? On some days, I like to wake up late. Question number 4. Which film did you watch last night? I walked to their shop to buy a watch. The plumber asks that man for help. I go for a drive in his car every morning. I stared at the wooden robot by the window. We were the last passengers to board the train. The boy fell into a deep ditch. So we have done these exercises. Now what we can do? In this video, we can also do order of adjectives. So, our next topic is, my next topic will be, hope this is clear. Next topic is order of adjectives. Okay, what is the order? Suppose in any sentences, if you are using more than two adjectives, so you should know that what should be the order of adjective. Look at this sentence. That green pretty diary is mine. Now see how many adjectives you have used, green and pretty. Two adjectives are there. Okay, so if you are using more than two adjectives, we should know the sequence, we should know the order of the adjective, that what should be the order of adjective. So does the sentence sound right to you? That green pretty diary is mine. Now read this sentence. That pretty green diary is mine. Both the sentences have two adjectives describing the noun diary. The second sentence reads better as the adjectives are placed in certain order. So this sentence is not correct, and this sentence, second sentence, that pretty green diary is mine, is correct. So we should know what should be the order of the adjective, and we have to place adjective in certain order. When we use more than one adjective to describe a noun, we have to follow a certain order. Look at the flowchart carefully to understand the order of adjective. So in your book, a flowchart is given. You have to look at that flowchart, and looking at that flowchart, we can understand that what should be the order and what should be the sequence. I will show you the flowchart. See, this is the flowchart. Okay, first number. We will write number. Okay, example of number 10, 13. Then we will write opinion. Example of opinion, pretty, rough. Then you will mention size, enormous, tiny, large, big, small. Then you will write age, old, young. After age, you can mention shape, round, rectangular, square, whatever it is. Then you will write color, red, yellow, origin and nationality, Indian, Spanish, American. Then material, velvet, cotton, purpose, for what purpose you, academic, industrial. So this is the order, and you have to follow this order if you are using more than two adjectives in your sentence. You have to use the adjective, you have to place the adjective in this order only. First number, then opinion, then size, then age, then shape, then color, then origin or nationality, material and purpose. Otherwise your sentence will be incorrect. So you should know the sequence, and you just follow this flowchart and follow this sequence. Now related to this, we have an exercise. Let's see what is the exercise. This exercise. This is page number 24. Okay. And the exercise is, rearrange the adjectives in bracket in the correct order and rewrite the sentences correctly. One has been done for you. Mother is very fond of her. And in bracket, three adjectives are mentioned. Jaipuri, new, red, sari. You have to place this adjective in correct sequence. So, mother is very fond of her new, red, Jaipuri saris. Okay, first we have to mention the age. If you look at the flowchart, first was you have to mention the, then you have to write the color, and then you have to write the, see, remember, this was the flowchart. Okay, this was the flowchart which we have done, and first we will write age, that was new. Okay, new was the age, and then what we have done, we have mentioned red. Red is what? Color. After age, you will write color, and then they have written Jaipuri. Jaipuri is origin. So, mother is very fond of her new red Jaipuri sari. In this way, you have to do. Next one, It was a, in bracket you have Turkish beautiful square rug. How you will do this? First you will write, it was a beautiful square Turkish rug. Beautiful is opinion, square is shape, Turkish is origin. So you have to place it in this sequence. Did you see those beautiful golden five plates? The sequence will be, did you see those five beautiful golden plates? I have bought rectangular big orange lunch box. The answer will be, I have bought a big rectangular orange lunch box. I think I forgot to write here lunch. Okay. The answer will be, I have bought a big rectangular orange lunch box. They decorated the card with pretty red paper leaves. The answer will be pretty red paper leaves. Sixth, the children brought a strange metallic short wand for the garden. Now, what will be the sequence? The children bought a strange short metallic wand from the garden. Okay. So, in this way, we have done this one. Now, thank you. Thanks for watching.